NIO is just a Chinese company that manufactures, designs, and sells smart electric vehicles, and they continue to innovate, and I'm going to be talking a little bit about that in just a few minutes. NIO is about 6 years old, so a relatively new company, and they IPO'd about 2 years ago. NIO builds their own internal system that consists of artificial intelligence, autonomous driving, which I believe to be the future of driving, as well as 5G technologies. And all this summed up kind of helps give NIO an edge in the EV market. NIO has had a huge run up lately, increasing over 1,800% in the last year and over 125% in the last 3 months alone. And I don't think they're anywhere near over. They're currently priced around $27 a share. And in the next few years, I think NIO will hit over $100 a share, but I'm not here to just give you my opinion. I'm gonna give you facts about NIO. That way you can gather information and assess whether you think NIO is a good investment or not. So in this video, I'm gonna be talking about exactly what is NIO. I'm gonna give a brief description on their cars. I'm gonna be talking about the past growth of NIO, the future potential growth, as well as I'm gonna talk about the CEO, William Lee, because I believe it is extremely important to understand the CEO of a company. And finally, I'm gonna be talking about risks associated with NIO. So a quick disclaimer, I'm a long-term holder in NIO. I started buying NIO when they were at $11 per share. And still to this day, I continue to add to my position, but I want this to be a non-biased video. So I'll be talking about all its great aspects as well as, you know, the risks involved with the company. As of right now, NIO offers 4 vehicles. The first one, the EP9, is a supercar that's really just for show. So I'm going to be talking about the other 3 cars that consist of the ES8, the ES6, and then more recently, they came out with the EC6, which is a sportier version of the ES6. I briefly want to show you guys NIO's EC6. That way you have an idea of what their product looks like. So it's a pretty nice, slick looking SUV. NIO definitely did well with their website. If you go and look around, it's pretty nice. And you can see the inside of their cars, super luxurious looking. It's a nice car really inside and out. And something I wanna talk about briefly is this little thing right here, which is called a Nomi. And it's a unique interactive personal digital assistant that is voice activated. And if you go on YouTube and you put in Nomi from NIO, you'll see that it's a pretty kind of nifty little companion. So whoever's talking in the car, it'll turn and face that person. And it can do simple things like control the AC, the power windows, and it can even take selfies. So it's, you know, great for Gen Z, a cool little feature that NIO added in there. I wanna talk about one more thing before I get into NIO's financials and their future prospects. And it's something that really separates NIO apart from their competitors. And the first thing is the fact that you don't have to buy the battery with the car. And the battery of an electric vehicle is the most expensive part of the car. So instead of paying whatever the sticker price is, you can take $10,000 off and not own the battery. And instead you pay a premium of, I think, $12 a month. So it makes it a lot more affordable. And the other thing, which is really big, is the fact that you can just go into these stations that NIO has around China and just swap your battery out. And the reason why this is such a big deal in China is that you have to realize a lot of people don't own their own homes. So whenever they get back from work or wherever they're coming back from, they can't just plug in their car and charge it overnight. So by having these stations around China, it makes their lives substantially easier. It's extremely convenient. It's something that actually China's government is trying to push electric vehicle companies to do. So NIO already has this, they're already on that boat, so it's fantastic. Briefly looking at the NIO stock, you can see that their market cap is about $37 billion. Their 52-week range is $1.36 from $29.40. Huge jump. And this is the reason why NIO wasn't getting a lot of coverage before, was simply because it was a penny stock. It was a very small company. Recently, JP Morgan came out and gave NIO a buy rating and gave a price target for the end of the year at $40. And I think Citigroup put a price target at $33. Now looking at NIO's second quarter financial results, we can see from the second quarter of 2019, they had 3,500 deliveries as compared to the second quarter of 2020 with 10,300, which is a huge jump. If we go back a few quarters and you start at the third quarter of 2019, you can see that there's a sizable increase from 2019, the third quarter, to the fourth quarter of 2019, then a big drop in the first quarter of 2020 due to COVID, and then it ramps up again in the second quarter of 2020. A few things to note down here, looking at the vehicle sales, they have a quarter over quarter increase of 177%, 146% year over year. Their total revenues have increased over 171% quarter over quarter and 146% year over year. So really good numbers. And then if you look at their net losses, so they're still not positive, but they have decreased their net losses by 64%. So they're definitely going in the right direction. And one more thing I want to note here, the vehicle margin looks like this is actually the first quarter where they have positive vehicle margins. So that's great news for investors for sure. Just looking at their third quarter delivery update, you can see it says NIO delivered 4,700 vehicles in September 2020, increasing by 133% year over year. They delivered 26,375 vehicles in 2020, increasing 113% year over year. So there's no doubt that NIO has showed some impressive growth, and we really don't have any reason to believe that it will slow down anytime soon, especially because they're planning on expanding into Europe in year 2021, where they think that their market cap will triple. So NIO's future prospects look really good for investors. Now I just want to talk briefly about the CEO of NIO, because it's a very important factor when buying into a company. So I'm briefly going to talk about his name is William Lee, his previous experiences owning companies. So in 1996, he founded his first company. It ended up not doing really well. In 2000, he founded another company called BitAuto, which was basically just an online website where you could buy and sell used cars. And after the first year of inception, it actually had lost $500,000, which for them was a lot. And William Lee's partner investors actually wanted out. So William Lee ended up buying out all of their shares. And then when he was asked later by an interviewer why he did that, he said because he truly believed in the product and he thought he would be able to turn it around. And he did exactly that. He ended up IPOing the company a few years later. And that company is actually the reason that he became a billionaire. So whenever you're looking at the CEO of a company, not only do you want to see the growth that we're seeing in NIO, but you want an honest, genuine CEO that truly believes in his or her product. And by what I've read on the internet, as well as the interviews I've seen on YouTube, William Lee seems to fit the CEO of NIO, that title, really well. So it's promising to me to see that. And finally, I want to talk about the risks associated with NIO. And the number one risk by far is the fact that it is a Chinese company. So on top of having the tension between the United States and China, you have Trump saying that he wants to ban all Chinese companies from the New York Stock Exchange, which honestly don't see happening anytime soon. But on top of the fact that even though NIO is traded on the New York Stock Exchange, which means they have to follow certain regulations, NIO is still a Chinese company. So we just don't have as much control as we would American companies. The two other risk factors associated with NIO is their competitors, like Tesla, XPeng, and a lot of other competitors, which I'm not too worried about at the rate that NIO is growing. And then finally, the fact that they are not profitable and they have a lot of debt. And although, you know, NIO isn't expected to be profitable quite yet, but at the rate that they're going at, it's very promising. And I don't think, you know, the investors have much to worry about. Anyway, guys, that's it for my video. I hope you guys liked it. Make sure you hit the like button if you did. And if you want to see more content like this, make sure you subscribe to my channel.